Good morning, student. Today I am discussing important topics of class 8. The chapter is metal and non-metals. This chapter is very important chapters. Then what is matter? The elements which has 1, 2, 3 electron, 1, 2, 3 valence electron is called metals. The elements which have tendency to lose electrons to form cation is called metal. Elements which have tendency to lose electron to form cation are known as metal. Just for example, sodium, atomic number is 11. Electronic configuration of sodium is 2, 8, 1. They have one valence electron. They lose its one valence electron to form Na plus ion. 2, 8 stable electronic configuration, like inert gas, like neon like configuration. Another example, magnesium, Mg, atomic number is 12. Electronic configuration is 2, 8, 2. They have two valence electrons. They lose its two valence electron to form Mg2 plus ion. To it a stable electronic configuration. Now aluminium, atomic number is 13. Electronic configuration is 2, 8, 3. They lose its three valence electron to form Al3 plus ion. Another example is like this, potassium. Potassium atomic number is 19. Electronic configuration is 2, 8, 8, 1. They have one valence electron and loses its one valence electron to form K plus ion. 2, 8, 8 argon like configuration. They are very stable electronic configuration. Now calcium, atomic number is 20. Electronic configuration is 2, 8, 8, 2. They have two valence electron. It loses its two valence electron to form Ca2 plus ion. 2, 8, 8 stable argon like configuration. Okay, these are called metals. Then what are the physical properties of metal? What are the physical properties of metal? First property is physical property of metal. And first is your metals are lustrous. Metals are lustrous. Lustrous means shining appearance. It's called lustrous. Metals are lustrous. Example, gold, silver, platinum, copper are lustrous. Second is, metals are sonorous. What is sonorous? They produce a ringing sound. When metal surface strike on its surface, it produces a ringing sound, is called sonorous. School bell is made of metals due to sonorous properties. Okay, gold, silver, platinum, iron, tin are sonorous. Third one is your metals are malleable. What is malleability? The property of metals which can beaten into thin sheet, which can convert it into thin sheets, are called malleability. Gold and silver is the most malleable metals. Other examples are platinum, iron, copper are malleable metals. Fourth property is your metals are ductile. Ductile means, what do you mean by ductility? The property of metal which can drawn into thin wires is known as ductility. They can convert it into wire is known as ductility. Gold and silver is the most ductile metals. Ductility of gold is highest. 1 gram gold can be drawn into 2 kilometer length of wire. So gold is the most ductile metals. Okay. Metals are good conductor of heat. Metals are good conductor of heat. In metals, particles are closely packed. One metal is heated, one particle vibrates to other particle and heat is transferred. Heat is transferred. This medium is known as conduction medium. Cooking utensil is made of metals because it is a good conductor of heat. Heat property is your metals are good conductor of electricity. Metals are good conductor of electricity. In metals, there is a free electron to move, so it is a good conductor of electricity. Silver is the best conductor of electricity, and mercury and lead is the poor conductor of electricity. Metals are hard. Metals are hard, except sodium and potassium is soft metal. It is cut by knives. Metals have high melting points and boiling points. In metals, particles are closely packed. So large amount of energy required to remove the electrons. So metals are hard. Sodium and potassium is a very soft metal. And tungsten is the highest melting point of metals, which has highest melting points. Gallium and cesium has lowest melting point. Gallium and cesium. Gallium Ga and Cs for cesium. Lowest melting point. And tungsten symbol is W. Highest melting point.
These are the physical properties of metal. Okay. Now I am discussing non-metals. Non-metal. What is non-metal? The elements which has 4, 5, 6, 7 valence electron is called non-metal. Or the elements which has tendency to gain electron to form anion is called non-metal. Elements which have tendency to gain electron to form anion are called non-metal. Just for example, fluorine, atomic number is 9, electronic configuration is 2-7. They have 7 valence electrons. They gain 1 electron to complete its octet. So, F minus charges and 2-8 stable electronic configuration like neon. Chlorine, 17, electronic configuration is 2-8-7. 2-8-7. They get 1 electron to form Cl minus and 2-8-8 argon like configuration, stable electronic configuration. Oxygen. Oxygen, atomic number is 8. Electronic configuration is 2-6. They have 6 valence electrons. They acquire 2 electrons to complete its octet. O2 minus 2-8 neon-like configuration. Nitrogen, atomic number is 7. The electronic configuration of nitrogen is 2-5. They require 3 electrons to complete its octet and gets N3 minus charges and 2-8 stable electronic configuration. Okay, these are called non-metals. Then, what are the physical properties of non-metal? Physical properties of non-metal. First property, it is non-lustrous. Non-lustrous. Non-metals are non-lustrous except iodine, which is lustrous. Except iodine, which is lustrous. It is non-sonorous. Non-sonorous. They do not produce ringing sound when they strike on its surface. So it is non-sonorous. Third property is your, it is non-malleable. Malleable. Non-metals are non-malleable. When non-metals are beaten, it breaks down, it brittles down into small pieces. Because the forces of attraction between particles in non-metal is very less. So it is brittle down. So it is non-lustrous. Non-malleable, I am saying. Non-malleable. Example, sulfur. phosphorus, it is non-ductile.
Non-metals are non-ductile, it cannot drawn into thin wire, so it is non-ductile.
Its properties, it is poor conductor of heat and electricity.
In non-metals, there is no free electron to move, so it is a poor conductor of electricity. Exception, graphite is a good conductor of electricity.
Exceptions are graphite.
Graphite is allotrops of carbon. It is allotrops of carbon. Carbon is three allotrops. Graphite, diamond, and Buckminster fullerene. They are the three allotrops of carbon. Non-metals are generally soft. Non-metals are solid and gaseous state. Exception, bromine is a liquid. Bromine is a non-metal which is liquid, and mercury is a metal which exists as liquid state. These are the properties of physical properties of non-metals. Now I come to the next topics, is your chemical properties of non-metal. Chemical properties of metal. Today,